Hello and welcome to Maths Table. In this lesson of Algebra, section 1.5, we are going to introduce you to algebraic equations. Before we go into detail into equations, let's take a simple example of a weighing scale balance, which we commonly see whenever we visit any fruit or vegetable shop. Now, when we buy some items from there, when we are going to pay for those items, we need to weigh them first, as we know that. So what we do is we place those items of unknown mass on one side of the balance, and we can check the amount or the mass of those items by comparing it with placing the known masses on the other side. And when the two sides are balanced, we say that the unknown mass is equal to the total known masses which were placed on the other side. So basically, our target when using the weighing scale balance was to balance the two sides. Basically, our problem is solved when the two sides are balanced. So what we should know about the scale balance, that the two sides, when balanced, they give us the unknown mass. And secondly, if it is already balanced and we add or remove equal masses on both sides, then it still remains balanced. So based on these concepts or these logics of weighing scale balance, we can understand the concept of algebraic equations. Now, from this example, which is written here, x squared plus 8x equal to 0, this is an example of an algebraic equation. Now, we can clearly see that as we had two sides in the weighing scale balance, the equation also has two sides, right and left side. So based on this, this can be compared with the weighing scale balance. And similarly, just like when we used to balance the two sides to obtain the unknown value of the mass, we also have to balance the two sides of the equation before we can find the solution of the equation. So basically, it is quite similar to the weighing scale balance. Now, how can we make the two sides of the equation equal? We can do it in two ways. Either we can make the right-hand side equal to left side, or we can make the left side equal to right-hand side. But here we can clearly see one thing, that the right side has only a constant number, basically, which is zero. And as we know that all the constants have a fixed value, so we cannot change the value of the right-hand side. So instead of converting the right side into left side, what we can do is we can see that in the left-hand side, we have the variable terms, which are x squared and 8x. So x is basically a variable which can take any real value. So we can substitute any value of x in the left-hand side to check that whether the left-hand side becomes equal to zero or not. So basically, we need to find a suitable value of x such that it balances the two sides of the equation. But it can be quite tedious by trying each and every value of x. So what should we do then? Well, the simplest way of balancing the two sides or making the left side equal to zero, we can recall a simple logic of multiplication of two numbers. Whenever we have two numbers being multiplied together, such as a and b, and if we want their product to be equal to zero, then we know that if two numbers are multiplied and any one of the number is zero, then the whole product becomes zero, such as when a is equal to 0, then whatever the value of b is, any number multiplied by 0 is 0. And similarly, when b is 0, then whether a has a negative value, positive value, or any value, still the answer will be equal to 0. So based on this logic, what we can do is we can convert the left-hand side of the expression into the product form, just like ab. This product form, as we have previously studied, is also called as factorized form. So basically, we need to factorize first the expression on the left side. Now by doing that, we can get the two expressions which are being multiplied together. And we can assume that in this case, a has a value of x, whereas b has a value of x plus 8. So just like that, when ab was equal to 0 based on either of these two, a and b, we can also say that either when x is equal to 0, then whatever x plus 8 is, the whole product will be 0. And similarly, if x plus 8 is equal to 0, then whatever the value of x is, that doesn't matter, because any number multiplied by 0 will also give us 0. So basically, our target is to find those values of x which makes the left-hand side equal to 0. So one value is clearly visible, that x, when x is 0, then the first expression will be 0, and hence x is equal to 0 is one of the two values. But the other value, x plus 8 is equal to 0, can be converted into x by simply minusing 8 on both sides, just like we studied in the case of the balance. If we remove the same as from both sides, just like here we have subtracted the same number on both sides, then in that case the equation would still remain valid. And so finally, plus 8 minus 8 will be cancelled out, and 0 minus 8 is equal to minus 8. So in this way, the two values x equal to 0 and x equal to minus 8 are two solutions of the equation, because when we substitute these values in the place of x in the equation, the two sides are each equal to 0 or balanced. So such values of x which, when substituted into the equation, balances the two sides, they are known as solutions of the equation. So that was the basic concept of how to solve an equation. Now let's take a few more examples of equations. Suppose that we need to solve the first equation, x squared plus 5x minus 6 equal to 0. Now we can see that the expression on the left side is a quadratic expression, and we also know that we need to factorize the left hand side before proceeding further towards finding the solution of the equation. So for factorizing the expression, we'll recall what we have studied in section 1.4 of factorization of quadratic expressions. What we studied there was that if an expression such as x squared plus 5x minus 6 is written, the last number minus 6 was a product of two numbers, such that those two numbers, when added together, they used to give us the coefficient of the middle term. So what we used to do is, we first used to break this set last number minus 6 into the two factors and check all possible combinations of two factors to see which of the combination contains two numbers which, when added together, give us plus 5, or the coefficient of the midterm. So we'll check them one by one. In the first combination, minus 3 plus 2 gives us minus 1. So this combination does not fit our criteria for this equation. Now in the second combination, minus 2 times 3 again gives us minus 6, but minus 2 plus 3 gives us plus 1. So again, it's of no use to us. The third combination, minus 6 times 1, gives us minus 6 plus 1 equal to minus 5, whereas we needed plus 5. So the last combination, in which minus 1 and 6 are multiplied together, they, when added together, minus 1 plus 6, give us plus 5. So we'll select this combination and break this midterm into two parts, plus 6x and minus x. Now, next step was to group the first two and last two terms together and take common factors between each of the two groups. So taking the common factors between each of the two groups, we finally get the factorized form of the expression on the left side as x plus 6 times x minus 1. Now in the next step, we'll recall the product rule AB equal to 0, that when either of the two numbers or two expressions, such as here, x plus 6 equal to 0 or x minus 1 equal to 0, then the whole expression on the left side becomes equal to 0 or equal to right hand side, which basically what we need. So we'll solve both of these two separate equations by subtracting minus 6 on both sides in the first one and by adding plus 1 on both sides to obtain the two solutions of the entire equation, which are minus 6 and plus 1. So this is how we can solve a quadratic equation. Now, in the second part, we again have a quadratic equation here, but it's written in a different form, in the completed square form. The left side, as we can see that the variable is written under the square sign. So the left-hand side expression is x plus 3 whole square. And what we need to do is we need to remove this square sign before finding the value of x. So for removing the square sign, we know that the opposite of square is square root. So we need to take square root on both sides, as we have discussed that we have to apply the same operation on both sides to keep that equation valid or balanced. But we have to check one thing, that whenever we take square root of a number, such as here we have 49 on the right side, so whenever we take the square root of 49 or any other number, we need to place the plus or minus sign here. This is because the 49 came from the number which was basically 7, but we don't know that whether 49 came from taking the square of plus 7 or taking the square of minus 7. Because as we know that the square of any number, whether it's a positive number or negative number, gives us a positive value. So we don't know whether this 49 came from plus 7 or minus 7. So when going backwards, we need to assume both of the values of 7, positive as well as negative. So in this way, we have basically two separate equations now, one with plus 7 and one with minus 7. So when solving these or balancing these two equations, we can find out the value of x by adding by subtracting 3 on both sides of the both equations. And finally, we can get 7 minus 3 equal to 4 and minus 7 minus 3 equal to minus 10. So this was how we can solve this kind of an equation or any other kind of equation by first either factorizing it and then solving the equation, or if it isn't written in a square form, then taking square root on both sides and doing it the same way further. So in the end, we would like to thank you very much for your valuable time in watching this video. We hope that this video was helpful for you. For any other queries or direct contact, you can message us or in our inbox on Facebook or on Instagram. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us there on Instagram and Facebook as well. Thank you very much and have a nice day.